Welcome to another PACCAR Powertrain Knowledge Minute on valve adjustment. This video covers valve adjustment on the EPA 2013 engines. This includes engine model years 2013 through 2016. Always refer to engine repeato by 8-digit chassis number for processes, torque specs, and lash adjustment specifications. Begin the valve adjustment process by disconnecting the batteries. Do this for safety reasons, as well as to protect the electronic modules on the truck. On most trucks, the air cleaner and primary air induction piping must be removed to access the valve cover. Be sure to cap off any openings in the air induction system to prevent dust and foreign objects from falling into the intake routing. These could damage the engine on startup. Remove all the hoses, brackets, and routings that will interfere with the removal of the valve cover. Then remove the valve cover attaching bolts. Before lifting the valve cover off the engine, it is a good idea to clean around the valve cover so that dirt and debris will be kept out of the engine. Now remove the valve cover. One of the PACCAR MX engine special tools is the 1903018 engine cranking tool. This should be used to align the appropriate marks on the flywheel for adjusting the valves. On this engine, the crankshaft will need to be rotated 6 times in 120-degree increments in order to adjust all the valves. There are 3 stop positions on the flywheel and front pulley related to adjusting the valves. These are 1-6, 2-5, and 3-4. You can position the crank in any of these positions to start the valve adjustment process. Once you stop on a mark, you will need to adjust the valves on whichever of the 2 cylinders has no open valves. Each stop will allow you to adjust the intake and exhaust valves on 1 cylinder. On the later EPA 2013 MX-13 engines, after mid-year 2015, there is a slight change in the flywheel. You will see a TDC mark next to the 1-6 mark. However, this does not alter the process. The valve lash measurement on the EPA 2013 PACCAR MX-13 engine is taken between the foot of the rocker and the valve bridge on both the intake and exhaust valves. The valve adjustments on the MX-13 engine are done with the standard adjusting screw and lock nut. Although it really doesn't matter if you start with the intake or exhaust valve, this tech has selected the intake valve rocker. Refer to PACCAR MX service documentation for the correct clearance specification. Since a small amount of residual oil between the rocker and the valve bridge, or between the rocker and the push tube, can affect the measurement, be sure to toggle the rocker before making the measurement. If adjustment is required, loosen the lock nut and with an Allen wrench, loosen or tighten the adjusting screw as needed. Be sure to check the adjustment each time you either move the adjusting screw or the lock nut. Even though you may take great effort to ensure that there is no movement, small movements can affect accuracy. Torque the locking nut firmly. As this video is being produced, that torque is 64 Newton meters, or 47 foot-pounds. However, you should always check for updates to any torque spec in repeato. Now move on to the other valve of the cylinder that you are adjusting. After all the valves are adjusted, clean the gasket retention groove and install a new valve cover gasket. Reinstall the valve cover on the engine. Run the valve cover bolts down gently, evenly, and snugly. You can do this by hand or with a power tool, but if you use a power tool, remember that the final tightening must be with a torque wrench. At the time of producing this video, the final torque on the valve cover should be about 9 Newton meters, which is 80 inch-pounds or 6.6 foot-pounds. Be sure to check PACCAR powertrain documentation before you start the job to determine if this spec has changed. Reinstall the air cleaner and the air induction piping to its original configuration. Remember to remove any protective caps as you reinstall. Make sure all the attaching bolts and clamps are tightened properly. As a final step in the process, reconnect the batteries. It is recommended that you follow the truck manufacturer's recommendations on the torque spec for the battery connections.